So welcome to this presentation where we're going to look at a first of a series in XenDesktop CCA where we'll look at the Citrix XenDesktop product and get you ready with a few study guides for the CCA exam. As always, you can follow these on my website, you can follow me on Twitter at The Urban Penguin and on Facebook. If you're interested in the Citrix Access Gateway, I've had a book published and I'm sure you would like it. So starting on our Windows 7 machine, this machine has been built and it's been built in our virtual desktop infrastructure. So this is built in Xen server. The machine already belongs to a domain, so we're going to log on as a domain account and we're going to install the virtual desktop agent, the VDA, onto this machine. This will become our master image, so once we've installed the agent on this machine, we'll allow it to reboot, but then we'll power it off and we'll use this machine as an image to create other machines. So we run the meta installer for XenDesktop, so I've got the XenDesktop DVD in, and we see we only have the choice to install the virtual desktop agent, not the XenDesktop components. The virtual desktop agent communicates to the desktop controllers and directly with clients once connection has been made. It will need the ICA ports opening up and port 80 to be able to talk back to the controllers. So as we start the install process, we've got the quick deploy or the advanced. We can choose quick deploy for our proof of concept system. We accept the license agreement and continue through. And we can see that it's going to install and open up the firewall ports. And we can allow the installation to continue. Once the install has completed, you can see a restart is required, but then once it has restarted, we'll shut the virtual machine down again in readiness for imaging. Now the fun part of XenDesktop, installing onto our 2008 R2 machine, we're going to install the complete proof of concept system other than the virtual desktop agents. So again, I'm going to run my meta installer based on .NET from the DVD. And this time when it starts up, you see I can't install the virtual desktop agents because they're for desktop operating systems. Install XenDesktop becomes available for our server-based systems. And then from here, we can see that we can install everything. And this would really become the proof of concept system because we wouldn't want to use this in a real world. So installing the controller, web interface, desktop studio, the desktop director, the management tools, the license server, and if you look down the bottom as well, the little tick box for SQL Express installing the database. So we have to have a farm database. Much of this is like XenApp. We have the license server, we have SQL as our farm database server. We don't have ZDCs, so we don't have the zone data collectors, but they are performed by dedicated devices with the XenDesktop controller. There is no localhost cache, all of the information is stored in the XenDesktop farm database, and the management tools then become Desktop Studio and Desktop Director. So continuing the install, we can see the firewall can be opened if necessary to open up the ports for the licensing server and other services. We can see the summary. And when we're ready, we can continue. Once the installation has completed, we can review any error messages here. Everything is okay. And the checkbox down the bottom enables us to configure XenDesktop after closing. So this is going to open up then our main Desktop Studio product. So we can see the web-based tool Citrix Desktop Studio now has opened. And if we want to continue with quick deploy, we can choose quick deploy, or you can see we can add the controller to an existing farm, or we could go, if you like, into the desktop deployment where we can get into the advanced or the normal configuration. Remember, here we just want an overview of what XenDesktop is about, so we're going to continue with the quick deploy. And we're taken into a very simple wizard to configure all of the elements that we need. So the first thing is the site name. Remember, everything else we know because we've got the database, the license server, all of this is on the one machine. We only have the option for the quick deploy if we've installed everything on the one machine. Now we've got to provide a connection into our hypervisor environment, and that could be Citrix, Hyper-V or VMware, but both Microsoft and VMware have to be managed. So with System Center Virtual Machine Manager or vSphere. So we're going to choose Send Server and configure the details to talk back to that virtual machine host. So we're putting in the IP address of a virtual machine host within the pool, and then the username and password that we can use. This could be Active Directory based, but I'm just using a local host. Username and password. And then continuing through our quick deploy wizard, we now connect into the Send Server host, and now we're determining which networks we want to connect our virtual machines to. So we're going to choose network 0, and the same sort of thing, the storage. So what storage to use? So by default it's choosing shared storage. We could use local storage, but that's not going to make the machines agile, so we're using shared storage here. And then which machine do we want to use as our master image? So this is the Windows 7 machine that we installed the virtual desktop agent on earlier. This needs to be powered off at the moment. Continuing through the wizard, we're now going to be asked how many copies of this. So we can see the default is to use machine creation services, part of XenDesktop 5 and above, to create 10 virtual machines. We're assigning one vCPU, 2 gigs of RAM, and a 24 gig hard drive space. And you can see the location in the Active Directory, the computer's container, where we're going to create AD accounts for the machines that we create. One of the big things is with XenDesktop is that we don't have to create the accounts in the Active Directory. The system does for you. We don't have to run sysprep. The system does all of this for you. So I'm just going to change the number of virtual machines to create the number of copies to 2, and then continue through, and we're going to assign then the virtual machines to our users. So who can use these virtual desktops? So we're just going to add in domain users and then continue to the summary, and then we'll allow machine creation services to do its job. So the wizard then will tick over for a few minutes as it duplicates the machine. Most of the time will be sent on machine creation services, and then we'll drop back once we've finished. So as it finished, then it says the local desktop's available on the local host, because remember we assigned the web interface to this machine. Everything is on this one proof of concept machine. So if we now have a look through Desktop Studio, if we move to the top of Desktop Studio and the node, we get the dashboard, and we can then see that I've got my two virtual machines and they've been assigned to a desktop group, QD desktops, our quick deploy desktops. Got one turned on at the moment and there are two available. Moving on the left through to machines, we can see then the catalog and the machines, the assignments. We can see the desktop groups. So here we take machines and make them available to users. This is where we assign them to domain users. And if we move down then to the configuration and controllers, this is then the XenDesktop controller that we installed. The hosts show our virtual machine infrastructure, and our licensing show the licenses in use, and we can see that we're using Express Edition here during the quick deploy or proof of concept system. Moving on to a client desktop and then browsing through to the web interface installed on our proof of concept system, we get then the Citrix XenDesktop logon page where we can put in our username, password and domains. This is the web interface, and this web interface could be shared between XenDesktop and XenApp. Certainly might want to play around with the wording and the graphics on this page. But then once we log on, we then should see a list of desktops available. I can click on the desktop icon. That's going to fire up then the ICA file, and the ICA file is going to give me a connection through to the Windows 7 desktops. Remember, I created two copies of my master Windows 7 image and will be connecting to one of those desktops. So we allow the desktop to be presented to me. So we can see the desktop then is shown to us, our Windows 7 desktop is shown to us through our desktop viewer. And our client, remember, doesn't have to be a Windows client. This could be Windows, Linux, Mac, iPad, or whatever Chromebook device or whatever we wanted to connect to. So we're providing ease of access to Windows 7 and all of its features through the ICA protocol. We could get to all of our keyboard shortcuts through the desktop viewer. A little welcome page here, which we can be prompted not to see that again. But yeah, in simple terms, we've gained access to Windows 7. Through our preferences, we could choose to scale the machine and see what features we have enabled in the high definition user experience. But hopefully this gives you a very brief idea of what the proof of concept system is. It is something designed to get you up and running quickly with XenDesktop. Come back and see us soon, and don't forget, if you need to see more on the Access Gateway, I have a book available. Thank you.